Okay. Let's call upon M. Chandra to deliver his speech.
Dear coach and fellow speakers, good afternoon. My speech today is about a movie that I enjoyed very much watching. In fact, I consider it the greatest movie I have ever watched so far. The movie that I am talking about today is about the Hollywood movie Gladiator. It's been a decade since I first seen the movie, but I still vividly remember my experiences that I had when I first watched it. I watched the movie at the Plaza Theatre on MG Road. I'm not sure how many of you remember the Plaza Theatre. This was the time when there was no Bangalore Metro. MG Road still had the green and beautiful promenade. And yes, there was a movie hall at the place where the current metro station stands on the MG Road. The movie is a fascinating drama of human emotions and behaviors, courage, resourcefulness, ambition, treachery, love and vengeance. It also provides a glimpse into the grandeur and might of the Roman Empire and how things existed at that point of time. The Gladiator is a film directed by Ridley Scott, the famous Hollywood director which many of you might know, and starring Russell Crowe. The main protagonists in this movie were the emperor Marcus Aurelius, is the old emperor, his son Commodus, and one of the commanders of the army, the Gladiator, who's handled by Russell Crowe. So the movie actually starts in the German forest where it was supposed to be the last frontier where the Roman army wins it. I don't know how many of you have seen this particular movie, but the forest that's shown there no longer exists. It was supposedly taken in England with a dense tall forest. They were supposed to be demolished by the government, and the director had taken a permission to withhold the demolition for 9 weeks when they shot this movie. Anyway, so the movie actually starts there, and after the war is won, the emperor is actually on his deathbed. When he has to choose who his successor is, he actually chooses the Roman, the commander Maximus, instead of his son Commodus. So when the Commodus comes to knows of this, he's not happy. So he actually goes and kills his father, the Emperor Marcus Aurelius. So the entire story is about how he comes back to Rome and then how he tries to keep his hold on the empire. So when Maximus comes to know of this, he actually tries to transfer the power back to the Senate and tries to get back to Rome. But the Commodus, the emperor, he actually hatches a plan to actually kill him. So the guards actually go and try to kill him, but he actually escapes it. And then the entire story is about how he goes back to save his family, and he actually cannot save it, and then how he's captured as a slave, and then he becomes a gladiator, he travels different parts of the empire, and then he finally comes back to the Rome as a gladiator. So there he actually enters the Colosseum, which everyone of you know. So there he fights many battles and he wins, and then finally he comes to face with the Roman Emperor himself, Commodus, and there he finally achieves his revenge by actually killing the Emperor. So there also been some criticism about the historical accuracy of the movie, and that the poetic license taken by the writers has been stretched too far. Marcus Aurelius died of plague. He was not killed by his own son as shown by the movie. The character of Maximus, the main hero, is totally fictional. It never existed in the Roman history. The character of Maximus never existed. He is probably a combination of four different historical figures. Narcissus, who was the real life murderer of Commodus. Spartacus, who led a significant slave revolt. Sinatra, a farmer who became a dictator, saved Rome from invasion, then resigned a 6-month appointment after 15 days, and Marcus, a trusted general and friend of Marcus Aurelius. Although Commodus engaged in a show combat in Colosseum, He was strangled by the wrestler Narses in his bar and not killed in the arena, and he reigned for several years, unlike the brief period shown in the film. The movie Gladiator has been hugely popular and widely acclaimed. It had a lot of impact on the movie industry and on the movie watching public. The movie generated a lot of interest in the Roman and classical history. In fact, the New York Times came up with the term the Gladiator Effect to describe this. The movie triggered a spike in the sales of books dealing with Roman history. It also led to Hollywood creating similar historical films. The set of films that you've seen in the last decade, Troy, Alexander, King Arthur, etc. And each of them have seen good success. I think the movie Gladiator owes its success to a gripping story, a high-class photography work, and outstanding dialogues ever written. I don't know how many of you have seen the actual fights on the Colosseum where the tigers are shown. The tigers are not real, they're actually a trick of photography, if you don't know that. The movie is, as I was saying, the movie has some outstanding dialogues ever written. The movie is replete with memorable quotes like, "He enters Rome like a conquering hero, but what he has conquered," when you actually, Commodus enters after murdering his father. And there's also some quotes where, like, at the end when the Maximus is in prison and the emperor is actually talking to him, he says, "The general who became a slave, the slave who became a gladiator, and the gladiator who defied an emperor." Striking story. I would like to conclude my favorite dialogue sequence in the movie, Gladiator, where Maximus, the gladiator, wins the battle of Carthage, is covered with a helmet, and the emperor comes into the arena and asks him to reveal his name, to tell his name. He just says Gladiator and he shows his back, walks. So the emperor is enraged and asks him to tell his complete name. The entire movie audience, there's a lot of suspense, what's going to happen. So after a few minutes, he turns his back, removes his helmet and says, "My name is Maximus Decimus Meridius, commander of the armies of the north, general of the Felix legions, and loyal servant to the true emperor Marcus Aurelius. Father to a murdered son and husband to a murdered wife, I'll have my vengeance in this life or the next. As far as I'm concerned, I'm ever happy to watch this movie again and again, in this life or the next." Thank you.
How many of you watched that movie? I watch it every time. A very good movie, right?